is a popular destination for many travellers and tourists, and the reputation is well deserved. But there are many aspects of life in this northern city that escape the notice of temporary visitors. One such gem is Baan Jang Nak, the home, workshop and museum of Khun Phet Wiriya, a master craftsman who has spent his life creating exquisite carved elephants. He is recognised as one of the best carvers in the north of Thailand. Baan Jang Nak is in a small soi in a village called Baan Buak Kao, about 18 kilometres east of Chiang Mai in San Kan Peng. Baan Jang Nak means, in the local dialect, a house full of elephants.
Welcome to Baan Jang Nak. This place is a museum. It's a place of local knowledge where you can learn more about elephants. Welcome. Please, come in. This is how we work. He is carving wood. The wood is first carved, then painted, and then sold. This carving uses the natural shape of the wood, then we carve into it to create more detail. It's a hard wood found locally, cassia wood. It's better than teak to get the details right. We draw a sketch first, then carve the crowd of elephants. You can see the elephants in different postures, different styles. Customers really like this. Many of the staff have been here for a long time. They learnt with me from an early age, that's 30 or 40 years ago. This is the way to preserve local skills and craftsmanship. That way, we can pass on the skills from one generation to the next. They will develop different styles and improve the carvings.
บ้านสุขครับเลขที่84ครับ
Many collectors from all over the world like to collect these carvings from Europe, America, and Asia. We make many of our own tools here from old motorcycle parts. We get the eyelashes from plastic brushes. This is another carving. It's the story of elephants in the forest. The forest is in its original natural condition. You can see the forest bull. It's probably extinct here in Thailand now. You can see monkeys too. This customer has been collecting our work for a long time. He lives in Bangkok and he will put it in his house. This is the start. We use steel to make the skeleton following the design. We cover it in wire mesh and then put on the cement. This is a medium-sized elephant, a teenager. This one will go to Lampang, to a cement company. This is the drawing that we design before we make the statue.
340 centimeters.
Each square is 25 centimeters, but the statue is 340 centimeters at its highest. It will be a white elephant with decorations, a cotton cover on the back, the head, a strap under its neck, and bracelets around its tusks and feet.
In his lifetime, one subject, above all others, has dominated his work, the elephant, which lies at the heart of traditional Thai culture. As a young man, Khun Phet trained with the greatest woodcarver in the north of Thailand, in the city of Lampang, Chiang Mai, and it was he who suggested to Khun Phet that he should study and carve elephants. Khun Phet spent many hours studying them in the open and from drawings. The result is that, unlike many of the elephant carvings found in tourist shops, Khun Phet's carvings are full of life and character. They almost seem alive. This is because so much skill, attention to detail and work goes into each carving. An average-sized elephant of about 15 centimeters takes 2 to 3 weeks to complete. After a spell in Bangkok, Khun Phet returned and started to make a living working from his family home. Wat Buk Khang, the temple in his village, gave him his first commission. This unusual twin-roofed temple has roots going back 600 years. It's one of only two in this style. The other is in Burma, but now it needed new carved doors and windows. Khun Phet was one of a number of carvers given the job of creating them. The work featured not elephants, but monkeys. Buk Khang means monkey well in the local dialect. At the bottom of the panel, Khun Phet carved his name. A kilometer further down the road is the larger village of Chair Chang. It was built near a river crossing. Chair Chang means elephant wallow. Chair Chang now sees few elephants. Motorbikes have replaced them, and a busy local market has grown up around the temple. Within the temple grounds, as in many temples throughout Thailand, the role of the elephant is remembered in statues and artwork. The grounds of Wat Chea Chang contains many elephant statues. Outside the entrance stands a life-sized elephant, sculpted in cement. It was made in Khun Phet's workshop. The museum is on the upper floor of the house and is full of an amazing range of carved elephants, drawings and other works of art. It's possible to go to visit with an organised tour, or, if travelling alone, just turn up. Khun Phet, his family and his workers are used to visitors and they are really friendly and helpful.
นี่เป็นผลงานช้างตัวแรกของผมที่ทำนะครับผมไปเรียนแกะสลักช้างไม้กับพ่อครูคำอ้ายเด็ดดวงตาเมื่อ
This is my first carving of an elephant. I went to learn with the teacher, Kam Ai, in Lampang in 1972, about 41 years ago. Although it is not beautiful, the others you see here are the younger brothers and sisters of this one.The 100 elephants I've sent around the world are all the children of this one. It's the first one I made, and I like to look after it. You can compare the later ones with this first one. I'm very proud of it.
น้องของตัวนี้หมดเลยตัวนี้มันเป็นตัวแรกที่ผมทำแล้วก็เก็บมันไว้อย่างดีนะครับจนปัจจุบันนะก็เป็นสิ่งที่เห็นการพัฒนารูปแบบที่แตกต่างจากยุคที่ผมไปเรียนเมื่อ40กว่าปีจนปัจจุบันผลงานออกมาก็แตกต่างกันมากครับเป็นความภาคภูมิใจมากครับที่ได้ชิ้นนี้ทั้งหมดนี่นะฮะเป็นเหมือนไฮไลท์ของบ้านจางนัก
This line of elephants is the highlight of Baan Jang Nak
หลากหลายอิริยาบถนะครับหลากหลายรูปแบบ
The elephants are in many different postures and styles
ความยาวทั้งหมดนี้ถึง12เมตร
It's 12 meters long and has about 123 elephants from my earliest work until now.
สะสมมาตั้งแต่ยุคแรกๆจนปัจจุบันก็มารวมกันติดบนไม้แล้วก็ให้เป็นคล้ายๆกับวิถีชีวิตของ
It shows the way of life of the elephant when it stays in the forest.
ลักษณะแบบไหน
They will walk together and stay together. It is a model to show the natural lifestyle of elephants, and people can learn from it.
อยู่ลักษณะแบบนี้คือเดินกันเป็นกลุ่มและบางกลุ่มก็อาจจะพักผ่อนนอนเล่นกันอะไรประมาณนี้นะครับอันนี้คือการจำลองวิถีชีวิตของช้างในธรรมชาติจริงๆที่ผมเข้าไปเรียนรู้ศึกษาข้อมูลจนเข้าใจมันได้ระดับนึงก็จำลองเอาไว้ที่นี่นะครับครับขอบคุณมากทุกคนที่มาเยี่ยมชมบ้านจังนัก
Thank you everyone
ที่มาเยี่ยมชมขอบคุณมากครับ